Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's look at 10 ways to make your iPhone more secure. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So you carry your iPhone with you everywhere. It's probably your most vulnerable of all of your devices. At any moment you could lose it or have it stolen. So how do you make it as secure as possible? Well, your first line of defense from anybody getting access to the stuff on your iPhone is your passcode. If you have a 4-digit passcode, that's a pretty weak security. Go into the Settings app and then go down to Passcode. It could be called Touch ID and Passcode or Face ID and Passcode depending upon which model of phone you have. Go into there. And you'll have to authenticate by entering your current passcode. And then you can set a new one right here. You'll have to authenticate again. And then you can enter your new passcode. Now here's where you want to look for this passcode options button. Tap that. And now you can choose to have a 4-digit numeric code, which you should never use today, or a custom numeric code. With a custom code, you can make it as long as you want. 6 digits is better, but going more than that is even better. If somebody's going to try to break into your phone, they're probably going to assume 6 digits since that's pretty common. Make it 7 or even 8 or 9 digits long. This makes it levels of magnitude harder to guess your passcode. Or better yet, choose custom alphanumeric code. And then you get to enter in using the alphanumeric keyboard. So you basically can set up a password instead of a passcode or even a longer phrase. Now also you want to avoid passcodes that can easily be guessed. Things that represent dates, for instance, can be easily guessed. So if it looks like a year and a month or a month and a day, try to avoid that. Matter of fact, the best thing to do is to get a random number and use that instead. So the number can't be guessed by somebody that knows you and knows numbers that you might typically use. Also, make it unique. Don't use the passcode anywhere else, because if your passcode is compromised somewhere else, like a PIN number for another service, then they could take that PIN number and then use that to get into your phone. Now there's another PIN number that you need to set on your phone, and it has to do with the SIM card that's in the phone. So somebody could theoretically pull the SIM card out of your phone, put it in another device, and while not accessing the stuff on your phone, could access stuff having to do with your mobile phone account. So go into Cellular and there look for SIM PIN. Go in there and turn that on and set it to something random. But of course make sure you record that in your password manager or write it down somewhere so you have it. For more information, check out this page at Apple's site. Now it doesn't make sense to even pay attention to any of the tips I'm going to give here unless you follow this next one, which is to use two-factor authentication for your iCloud account. Your iCloud account is tied into your iPhone in so many different ways, so we want to make sure that's protected. Otherwise somebody can get access to your information and they don't even physically have access to your phone. So in your iCloud settings, go to Password and Security. And in there, make sure you have two-factor authentication turned on. Most Apple users do now, as there's a lot of things you can't do unless you're using two-factor. But if you haven't yet gone over to two-factor for your iCloud account, then forget all the rest of these tips and take care of that now. Here's more information from Apple. Now while your iPhone may be secure, your connection to the internet may not be. One of the easiest ways for you to be compromised there is to be using a non-trusted Wi-Fi source. So in other words, you're somewhere using somebody else's Wi-Fi and either they're looking at your data as it goes through their Wi-Fi network, or maybe they're not even doing it, the Wi-Fi equipment's been compromised itself. So you want to make sure you go to Wi-Fi and then turn off Auto Join Hotspot, or at least set it to Ask to Join. And then try to avoid using other people's Wi-Fi unless you actually trust them. Like for instance your Wi-Fi at home or your Wi-Fi at work or at school. Now it's not really possible to be compromised by an app that you install because the App Store is pretty locked down by Apple. But if that's going to happen, it's going to happen by that app installing some sort of profile. A profile gives the app higher level of access to your system than just having the app installed by itself. To check to see whether or not you've allowed any apps to install profiles, go into General and then go down here and look to see if there's an entry right around here for profiles or profile device management, things like that. It's usually just before the settings for VPN. I don't have any installed here, but if I did have one, like say a beta test profile from Apple, it would appear right here. I could then tap on it just like I can with VPN and see what I have installed and remove anything. So if you see something that's there listed as a profile, you go into it, If you don't know what it is, research it right away to figure out what's going on and delete it if you need to. Now if your iPhone does get stolen, one of your best lines of defense is to basically disable it, wipe it remotely. But to do that, you have to set things up first. You have to be proactive. So go into your iCloud settings here, then look for Find My. Go in there and make sure Find My iPhone is turned on. If that's turned on and your iPhone is stolen, you can now go to iCloud.com, go to Find My iPhone there, and from there remotely wipe your iPhone. Now let's go back to looking at passcode options. One thing you want to pay attention to is the require passcode setting. It should be locked in immediately, but depending upon other settings you have, it may not be. Make sure you have it set to immediately. Otherwise, you can lock your phone and somebody can then take it and still get access to things without a passcode for a period of time. Another setting to look for is here at the bottom, and it's USB accessories. And you see how I have that turned off. Basically, with this turned off, if somebody connects something to the Lightning port on your iPhone, it has to be unlocked to give access to that device. One of the main ways that somebody can break into an iPhone is to take it, hook it up to a piece of hardware that then installs software on the iPhone. But with this turned off, it can't install that software until the phone is unlocked. Now also you want to look at all these settings up here and you can see what is available on the lock screen. So your phone is locked, but these things can still be accessed. For instance, Siri can still be asked some questions. Control Center can be brought up. Wallet can be brought up. Now all of these have uses on the lock screen, so you may want to have them on. But you definitely want to think about all of these in terms of security. And if you want to set up your phone for high security, you may want to disable many of them. For instance, with Notification Center on, somebody who has your phone may be able to see notifications that have private information on them even though your phone is still locked. And Reply with Message may allow somebody who sees a message coming in to send back a canned response, making it look like everything is okay even though they have actually taken your iPhone from you. Now look at the setting here at the bottom, Erase Data. If you turn this on and enable it, what will happen is if there are 10 wrong tries of a passcode, then all the data on your iPhone will be erased. Now this is important because without this turned on, it means that somebody can basically keep trying different passcodes until they guess the right one. And if there's a machine that's doing that, it can just keep going and keep going until it gets the right passcode. But with this enabled, it means it only gets 10 tries, which is pretty useless if you're using a good strong passcode. It's never going to guess it in the first 10 tries. The phone will be erased and then all your data will be safe. So here's one last tip, and that is to force your iPhone into a mode where passcode is required. You see, you have an iPhone that either has Touch ID or Face ID, which is really convenient for you to be able to get quick access to your phone without having to keep entering in the passcode every time. But there are some far-fetched scenarios where somebody could force you to use Face ID or Touch ID to unlock your phone. To disable that, all you need to do is quickly go to the mode where you're basically trying to turn off your phone, but you don't need to turn it off. So for instance, on some older phones, it may be just holding the side button for a few seconds until it gets into that mode. And on newer phones, you hold the side button and either the volume up or volume down for a second or so, and it will go into that mode. And then watch what happens. You can see it goes into slide to power off mode. If I cancel now, and you can see if I try to use Touch ID, it says your passcode is required to enable Touch ID. So I've set it up in that mode. So if you feel you're in a situation where you really want to secure your iPhone just in that moment, do this, try it out now, practice it so you know how to do it. That way you know how to quickly secure your iPhone and require a passcode if the need arises. So there are various different ways to increase the security of your iPhone. Some of these are a little more extreme than others, but if you do nothing else, at least turn on Find My iPhone, use two-factor authentication, and have a decent random passcode for your iPhone. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.